हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम हर्षला दत्ते, सीनियर लेक्चरर ऑफ डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर इंजीनियरिंग. इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू द टॉपिक कंप्लायंस स्टैंडर्ड्स फॉर इंफॉर्मेशन सिक्योरिटी. दिस आर द यूनिट आउटकम. आफ्टर लर्निंग दिस वीडियो लेक्चर यू विल डिस्क्राइब द कंप्लायंस स्टैंडर्ड्स फॉर इंफॉर्मेशन सिक्योरिटी. द लर्निंग आउटकम्स ऑफ दिस वीडियो लेक्चर आर इंफॉर्मेशन सिक्योरिटी मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम दैट इज ISMS, नीड ऑफ ISMS, PCDA मॉडल दैट इज ISO IEC 7001 2005, ISO 7001 सर्टिफिकेशन प्रोसेस, बेनिफिट्स ऑफ ISO 27001, BS दैट इज ब्रिटिश स्टैंडर्ड 25999, IIT IIL दैट इज इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी इंफॉर्मेशन इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर लाइब्रेरी, एंड COBIT दैट इज कंट्रोल ऑब्जेक्टिव्स फॉर इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी. लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द इंफॉर्मेशन सिक्योरिटी मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम. इट इज अ सिस्टमैटिक एंड स्ट्रक्चर अप्रोच टू मैनेजिंग द इंफॉर्मेशन सो दैट इट रिमेन्स सिक्योर. ISMS implementation includes policies, process, procedures, organizational structures, and the software and the hardware function. The ISMS implementation should be directly influenced by the organization objectives, security requirement, process employed, size, and structures. So what is the need of ISMS? As organization and their information systems and networks are exposed with the security threats such as frauds, fire, floods, sabotage from the wide range of sources, the increasing number of security breaches has led to increasing information security concern among the organization worldwide. The ISMS can be based on the two international standard, that is ISO IEC 27001 2005 and ISO IEC 27002 2005. So let us discuss the first standard, that is ISO IEC 27001 2005. It is based on the PDCA model. It is a requirement for the information security management system. It specifies the requirement for establishing the implementing and operating, monitoring, reviewing, maintaining, and improving the documented ISMS within the context of the organization overall business risks. It is based on the PDCA model, that is plan, do, check, and act. In plan, we establish the ISMS. In do, we implement and operate the ISMS. In check, we monitor and review the ISMS. And in act, we maintain and improve the ISMS. The next is the ISO IEC 27002 2005. It is a code of practice for information security management. It provides a catalog for the controls that can be implemented for the ISMS. The standard comprises of the 11 security areas, 39 controls objectives, and 133 controls. The 11 security areas of the ISO IEC 27002 are listed in below figure 2. That is security policy, organizing information security, assets management, human resources security, physical and environmental security, communication and operation management, access control, information system acquisition, development and maintenance, information security incident management, BCM, that is business continuity management, and the compliance. Let us see the advantages of ISMS certification. What kind of advantages gained by the organization if any organization do the ISMS certification? So it provides the following advantages. It provides a structured way of managing the information security within an organization. Also provides the independent assessment of the organization conformity to the best practices agreed by the community of the experts of ISMS. It also provides the evidence and assurance that an organization has complied with the standards requirement. This certification also enhances information security governance within the organization, also enhances the organization global positioning and reputation. ISMS certification also increases the level of information security in the organization. Let us see the ISO 27001 certification process. So in this process there are 3 steps and 3 audits, total 6 steps. So after each steps there are the auditing is required. So let us see stage by stage. First step is the preparation and documentation. So in first step, we implement the ISMS ensuring integration with an existing management system, process and culture. Also identify the interested parties and application legislation. Also complete a risk assessment treatment plan. develop the statement of applicability and identify the accredited certification body. So these are the works comes under the preparation and documentation stage. After that, there is a stage one audit. So in stage one audit, we are auditing whatever we do in a stage step one. So it checks all the documentation to confirm that all the management systems implement elements are completed and understand how to prepare you are for stage two and whether you understand the requirement of the standards, confirm the scope of the certification and also ensure the plan in the place for full implementation of your ISMS and plan the program for the stage two. These all these steps comes under the stage one audit. After that, there is a step three, that is ISMS implementation. In ISMS implementation, we ensure all the control implemented, we complete the internal audit, including the audit of all the controls, also complete a management review, also it maintains and review KPIs and corrective actions, maintain the continual improvement. After that, there is a stage 2 audit. In stage 2 audit, we have seen that whether we are completed all the steps in the step 3 or not, that is ISMS implementation. So in stage 2, these are the some works comes under the stage 2 audit. Confirmation of implementation of ISMS, including interview with senior management, review of internal audits and audit trails, management review, compliance with the legal duties and check on the controls, staff awareness and compliance plans and program for an ongoing visit. So in stage 2 audit, we also draw at the last plan of the how to program to for ongoing the visit. Then in next is the ISMS maintenance and improvement. Ensure all the controls continue to be implemented, maintain a risk-based internal audit program, including the audit of all controls. Also, it includes the complete management reviews, maintain reviews, KPIs and corrective actions. It also maintains the continual improvement. After the fifth step, there is the third audit, that is ongoing audit. So it is done in 6 or 12 monthly checks to ensure ISMS effectively operated and maintained with the evidence of continual improvement. So this is what the ISO 27001 certification process. So first step is the preparation and documentation. In next step, there is a stage one audit of preparation and documentation. In third step, there is the ISMS implementation. In fourth step, there is a stage two audit of ISMS implementation. In fifth step, there is the ISMS maintenance and improvement. And in sixth step, there is the ongoing audits of the ISMS maintenance and the improvement. Next is the benefits of the ISO 27001 certification. What kinds of benefits you will get after doing that certification of ISO 27001. So these are the some advantages. It provides you confidentiality of the information. Also, it minimizes the IT risks, possible damage, and a co-sequential cost. Also, it provides a competitive edge due to the recognized standard. It also increases in trust with respect to partners, customers, and the public. This certification also it is a structured method to address the compliance requirement. It also fulfills the internationally recognized requirement. It also provides a systematic detection of the vulnerability. Also, it is a lower cost. Also, it provide a control of the IT risks. It also reduces the chances of security breaches within your IT environment. So these are the some benefits you will get after the ISO 27001 certification. The next standard is a BS 25999, that is British standards 25992. It is issued in 2007 and quickly become a main standard for business continuity management. It is specially used for the BCM, that is business continuity management. The following are some of the key procedures and documents required by BS 25992. The first is the scope of BCMS. It is a precise identification of the part of the organization to which BCM is applied. Then BCM policy, it defines the objectives and responsibilities, etc. Then human resource management, business impact analysis and risk assessment. It also defining the business continuity strategy, business continuity plan and maintenance of plan and system and improvement. Next is a ITIL, that is Information Technology Infrastructure Library. It is a framework designed to standardize the selection, planning, delivery, maintenance and the overall life cycle of IT, that is information technology services within a business. The goal is to improve efficiency and achieve predictable service delivery. So what is the need of ITIL? So the areas where the ITIL play an effective role are as given follow. IT and business strategic planning, integrating and aligning IT and business goal, implementing continuous improvement, acquiring the retaining the right resources and skill sets, reducing the cost and the total cost of ownership, demonstrating the business value to IT, it also achieve and demonstrating the value for money and return on investment, also measuring IT organization effectiveness and efficiency, developing the business and IT partnership and relationship, improving the project delivery success and managing the constant business and IT change. These are the some benefits of ITIL standard. It provides the clear structure of organization. It also controls the infrastructure services. It also improves the decision making. It also gives you the financial management. It also improves the service availability and it also increases the customer satisfaction. The last framework is the COBIT. COBIT stands for Control Objective and Information and Related Technology. It is a framework created by ISACA, that is Information System Audit and Control Association, for IT governance and management. It was designed to be a supportive tool for managers and allow bridging the crucial gap between the technical issue, business risks and the control requirement. COBIT is truly recognized guideline that can be applied to any organization in an industry. Overall, COBIT ensures quality, control and reliability of the information system in an organization, which is also a most important aspect of every modern business. COBIT has 5 principles. First is meeting stakeholder needs, covering the enterprise end-to-end, applying the single COBIT has 5 principles. The first is meeting stakeholder needs, covering the enterprising end-to-end, applying a single integrated framework, enabling a holistic approach, and separating the governance from the management. So these are the principles on which COBIT is based. The next is the enablers. There are 7 COBIT enablers. So these are the process, organization structure, culture, ethics and behavior, information, services, infrastructure and application, people, skills and competencies, so and principles, policies and framework. So these are the COBIT enablers. Totals there are 7 COBIT enablers. Together, the principles and the enablers of the COBIT allow an organization to align its IT investment in its objective to realize the value of the total investment. So now we will see the comparison between the standards of ITIL, ISO 200000 and COBIT. So there are 4 parameters on which we are going to do the comparison. The first is ownership. In ITIL, a service management framework owned by the XLOs, ISO, a service management standard from the ISO Geneva, and COBIT, an IT governance framework from the ISACA. Implementation parameter, in ITIL, as a framework, it can be adopted and adapt to suit IT organization needs. In ISO 20000, as a standard, it has to be implemented in spirit and principles by IT organization. And in COBIT, as a framework, it can be adopted and adapted to the suit IT organization need. Certificate. The ITIL certificate awarded to individual only and can be awarded to an organization. ISO 20000 certificate awarded to organization and individual as an assessor, implementer, etc. And COBIT certificate awarded to individuals only and can be awarded to an organization. And last parameter is scope and coverage. IITIL is a framework of best practices for service management and it's complementary to ISO 20000. The ISO 20000 standard is complementary to IITIL and a COBIT framework has a more scope coverage compared to IITIL. Thank you.